Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum students. Today I will be discussing with you people determinants of pathogenesis. In other words, what are the factors which determine the pathogenicity of bacteria? Pathogenicity means disease causing ability of the bacteria. So we can say that the factors which we will be discussed today, these factors are responsible for disease causing ability of the bacteria. Okay students, let's start. Determinants of pathogenesis of bacteria. Students, I will be discussing with you one by one these factors. Number one, most important, is mode of transmission. Mode of transmission. Students, mode of transmission means the mechanism, the route, the process through which bacteria or infecting microorganism cause infection in the host. We have different modes of transmission of bacteria which cause disease in the host. Number one, human to human. First mode of transmission is human to human, that is bacteria cause infection from one human being to the another. In these mechanisms we have four different varieties. Number one, direct contact. Direct contact. When two persons comes in direct contact with each other, bacteria are transmitted from one to the other. Number two, indirect contact. Indirect contact. Okay. Number third, transplacental. Transplacental means through placenta, that is from mother to the fetus. Bacteria and other infecting microorganisms, they can be transmitted from mother to the fetus. And last one, bloodborne. Bloodborne. Students, these are four different modes of transmission from human to human: direct contact, indirect contact, transplacental transmission, and blood-borne transmission. Now, next is from non-human to human. Non-human to human. That is, the infecting microorganism, they spread from non-human source to the humans. Examples are swine source, swine, water source, water source, animal source, animal source, and students, last one, fomites. Fomites. different fomites are the objects like bed sheets, clothes of the infected person, personal usage and objects of the patient. These are called fomites. Now these are two main modes of transmission of bacteria, human to human and non-human to human. Now students, second important determinant of pathogenesis is portal of entry. Portal of entry. It means the passage through which infecting microorganism enters into the host. There are four common routes of entry of bacteria into the host. These are number one, respiratory tract. Okay, respiratory tract, gastrointestinal tract. Okay, number third, skin. And number fourth, genital tract. Students, these are four common routes of entry of infecting microorganisms into the host. Okay? Now, third determinant of pathogenesis of bacteria is adherence. Adherence means attachment of bacteria or microorganism to the host. Students, adherence depends upon structure of the bacteria. And structure, most important, pili. Pili helps in the attachment of bacteria on the surface of the host cells. Okay, pili. Number two, glycocalyx. Glycocalyx. Student, glycocalyx also helps in the attachment of bacteria on the surface of host cells. Now, third point was adherence. Number four. Students, number four, invasion. Gee, students, number fourth point of determinants is invasion. Invasion means attack of bacteria on the host cells. Students, there are different types of enzymes which causes invasion of bacteria on the host cells. They destroy host cells in different type, in the ways. These enzymes are, for example, coagulase enzyme. Coagulase enzyme, it leads to increased fibrin formation. As a result, there is increased clotting tendency in the host blood. Coagulase enzyme, hyaluronidase enzyme, hyaluronidase enzyme, collagenase enzyme, collagenase enzyme, and students, leukocytes. Leukocytes. These are the four elements which cause invasion of bacteria on the host cells and leads to their destruction. These are mostly enzymes. Coagulase enzyme, hyaluronidase enzyme, collagenase enzyme, and leukocytes. Students, next point of determinant of pathogenicity is inflammation. 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 Students, bacteria cause inflammation in the host by two mechanisms or two types of inflammation they cause. Number one is pyogenic inflammation. Pyogenic inflammation. And number second type of inflammation is granulomatous inflammation. Granulomatous inflammation. Students, in pyogenic inflammation, there is pus formation in the host cells. And pus is mainly constituted by neutrophils. Okay, granulomatous inflammation. In this type of inflammation, there is granuloma formation in the host. What is granuloma formation? Students, in very simple words, granuloma is a deposit of transformed macrophages, which are called epithelioid cells. These are epithelioid cells are transformed macrophages. Now, next point is toxins. Toxins. Students, bacteria produce two types of toxins, exotoxins and endotoxins. Please be very clear in your concepts that exotoxins are produced by mostly gram-positive and some gram-negative bacteria. On the other hand, endotoxins, they are integral part of cell wall of gram-negative bacteria only. They are liberated from the cell wall when the gram-negative bacteria, they die off. Okay? These exotoxins and endotoxins, they are responsible for different clinical abnormalities in the host. For example, tetanus toxoid, which causes tetanus, and in tetanus there is increased muscular contraction in the host. Okay, now after toxins we have immunopathogenesis. Immunopathogenesis. Students, it is not always the bacteria which causes destruction in the host. It may be immunopathogenesis means immune status of the host sometimes causes destruction in the host. For example, rheumatic fever and glomerulonephritis. It is actually the production of antibodies against the invading bacteria in rheumatic fever. But these antibodies, they also destroy some of the structures of the host, for example, heart valves, nervous system, joints. So bacteria is not directly destroying the host. It is the immunological response of the host which is causing infection or disease symptoms in the host. So students, these were the main factors which determine the disease causing ability of the bacteria. That's why we have called them determinants of pathogenesis of the bacteria. Thank you very much and Allah Hafiz.